Hi friends, how are you? Hope you all are well and doing good job. Welcome you all in my YouTube channel. Today, in this video, I am going to explain about synthetic application of ethyl acetoacetate. So this is first application, synthesis of alpha beta unsaturated acid. This involves base catalyzed reaction of ethyl acetoacetate with an aldehyde or ketone followed by acid hydrolysis. This is ethyl acetoacetate, this is aldehyde, react with in the presence of this reagent forming these molecules. On hydrolysis, this bond will break here and this bond will break here, means hydrolysis will occur in these two position and forming crotonic acid. Crotonic acid is an alpha beta unsaturated acid. So this is crotonic acid. You see here CH3CH double bond CH CO COOH. This is crotonic acid. You can synthesize this crotonic acid with the help of ethyl acetoacetate. This is first application. Now come to second applications. Alkylations of sodium ethyl acetoacetate is first done with the one molecule's alkyl halide and then with the another molecule of alkyl halide followed by acid hydrolysis. So dialkyl acetic acid, here you see ethyl acetoacetate, this is sodium salt of ethyl acetoacetate, this is alkyl ethyl acetoacetate, and further react with another alkyl halide. Again this both proton is replaced by alkyl groups, and finally on hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis in the presence sodium hydroxide forming dialkyl acetic acid. Both are same or may be different, and this is acetic acid. So you can synthesize dialkyl acetic acid according to your choice. Now come to third applications. Synthesis of higher dicarboxylic acid. The reactions of sodium ethyl acetoacetate, two molecules with an alkaline diiodide followed by acid hydrolysis gives a normal dicarboxylic acid. Here you can see two molecule ethyl acetoacetate react with sodium ethoxide forming anion two molecules, and reaction with alkylene 1,2 diiodide forming these big molecules. On hydrolysis, this position, this position, this position, this position, acid hydrolysis give adipic acid, and this is acetic acid and this is ethanol. Now come to the third synthesis, synthesis of succinic acid. The reactions of sodium ethyl acetoacetate with ethyl chloroacetate followed by acid hydrolysis give succinic acid. You can see here ethyl acetoacetate, sodium salt of ethyl acetoacetate, chloroethyl acetate forming this molecule, and on hydrolysis this position, this position, these positions in acidic hydrolysis gave succinic acid, acetic acid and ethanol. So you can synthesize succinic acid start from ethyl acetoacetate. Now come to the fourth application of ethyl acetoacetate, synthesis of alkyl acetic acid. This involves the reaction of sodium ethyl acetoacetate with an alkyl halide followed by acid hydrolysis. So you can see here ethyl acetoacetate two times, one time sodium ethoxide, second time alkyl halide forming alkylated ethyl acetoacetate. On acid hydrolysis you will get substituted acetic acid or alkyl acetic acid. Now come to the next synthesis of methyl ketones, start with the ethyl acetoacetate. This involves the reaction of sodium ethyl acetoacetate with alkyl halide followed by ketonic hydrolysis. You can see here, this ethyl acetoacetate react with this reagent forming this compound upon ketonic hydrolysis and after heating giving carbon dioxide, and this methyl ketone is forming and ethanol is forming. So you can synthesize according to your choice, R should be methyl, ethyl, propyl, anything, methyl ketones. Now come to the next synthesis applications of ethyl acetoacetate, synthesis of 1,3-diketone. This involves the reaction of sodium ethyl acetoacetate with acid halide followed by ketonic hydrolysis. This ethyl acetoacetate reactions with this reagent forming, this is acyl substituted ethyl acetoacetate, ketonic hydrolysis giving 1,2-diketones. Here ketonic hydrolysis occurs, so CH3CO CH2 CO CH3, carbon dioxide and C2H5. Now come to the another applications of ethyl acetoacetate, synthesis of antipyrenes. Ethyl acetoacetate react with phenyl hydrazine to give antipyrene. This is phenyl hydrazine, this is ethyl acetoacetate, remove water, ethanol, and forming this structure is known as antipyrenes. This is heterocyclic compounds also. Now next applications, synthesis of 4-methyl uracil. Ethyl acetoacetate enol form reacts with urea in the presence of phosphoryl chloride to give 4-methyl uracil. This is enol form of ethyl acetoacetate. This is urea in presence of phosphoryl chloride. This 4-methyl uracil is formed. So hope this video will be helpful to you for the preparation of TDC part 2. And if you like this video, then subscribe it, share it with friend. Now I am going to tell in Hindi. Hindi mein aapko main bata raha hu ke ethyl acetoacetate ka kya application. To isse ethyl acetoacetate se shuruaat karke aap crotonic acid bana sakte hain. Kaise? Ye ethyl acetate hai, ye aldehyde koi hoga. Base ke presence mein ye acyl substituted ethyl acetate banayega. और उसके बाद एसिड हाइड्रोलिसिस करेंगे तो ये क्रोटोनिक एसिड का सिंथेसिस कर सकते हैं. सेकेंड एप्लीकेशन है कि डाई अल्काइल एसिटिक एसिड है. पहले आप सोडियम सॉल्ट बना लेंगे, उसके बाद अल्काइलेटेड बना लेंगे, उसके बाद फिर दूसरे अल्काइल ग्रुप को अटैच करेंगे, फिर एसिड हाइड्रोलिसिस करेंगे तो डाई अल्काइल एसिटिक एसिड बन जाएगा. ये डाई अल्काइल इस तरह के कोई भी डेरिवेटिव बना सकते हैं. थर्ड में हायर डाइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड आपको बनाना है. ये स्टार्ट फ्रॉम इथाइल एसिटोएसिटेट, फिर आप सोडियम सॉल्ट बना लेंगे, फिर उसको हाइड्रोलिसिस करेंगे, एडीपी एसिड मिल जाएगा और या एसिड हाइड्रोलिसिस, तो एडीपी एसिड भी आप बना सकते हैं. सक्सिनिक एसिड सिंथेसिस, इथाइल एसिटोएसिट है, सोडियम सॉल्ट बना लेंगे, ये कंपाउंड्स बनेगा, इसका एसिड हाइड्रोलिसिस करेंगे, सक्सिनिक एसिड मिलेगा. उसके बाद है सिंथेसिस ऑफ अल्काइलेटेड एसिटिक एसिड, कि फिर आप इथाइल एसिटोएसिट से सोडियम सॉल्ट बना लेंगे और फिर अल्काइलेटेड बना लेंगे, उसके बाद एसिड हाइड्रोलिसिस करेंगे तो अल्काइल एसिटिक एसिड, यहाँ पर आर मिथाइल इथाइल प्रोपाइल कुछ भी होगा. उसके बाद सिंथेसिस ऑफ मिथाइल कीटोन, इथाइल एसिटेट का सोडियम सॉल्ट बना लेंगे, अल्काइलेटेड कर लेंगे, कीटोनिक हाइड्रोलिसिस करके मिथाइल कीटोन बनाएंगे. उसके बाद 1,3-diketone की सिंथेसिस, इथाइल एसिटोएसिट से स्टार्ट करेंगे, सॉल्ट बना लेंगे, उसका एसाइल डेरिवेटिव बनाएंगे, इसका कीटोनिक हाइड्रोलिसिस करेंगे, 1,3-diketone बना लेंगे. उसके बाद सिंथेसिस ऑफ एंटीपायरिन, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम इथाइल एसिटेट से, ये हाइड्रोजीन का डेरिवेटिव है, यहाँ से वाटर इथेनॉल रिमूव होगा, एंटीपायरिन ये बन जाएगा. लास्ट है सिंथेसिस ऑफ 4-methyl यूरासिल. आप इनॉल फॉर्म इथाइल एसिटेट को लेंगे, यूरिया लेंगे, फास्फोराइल क्लोराइड के साथ उसको रिएक्शंस कराएंगे, ये 4-methyl यूरासिल बनेगा. आपको होप ये वीडियो पसंद आया हो. अगर पसंद आया तो आप शेयर कीजिए अपने फ्रेंड से. थैंक यू.